Good morning. When God sent his servants, what did they do? And then what did God do? We're looking at Jeremiah chapter 44 now in verses 1 to 6. The word that came to Jeremiah concerning all of the Jews who dwell in the land of Egypt, who dwell at Migdol, at Tampanes, and Noph, and in the country of Pathros, saying, Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, You have seen all the calamity that I have brought on Jerusalem and on all the cities of Judah, and behold, this day they are a desolation, and no one dwells in them, because of their wickedness, which they have committed to provoke me to anger, in that they went to burn incense and to serve other gods, whom they did not know, they nor you nor your fathers. However, if I have sent to you all my servants, the prophets, rising early and sending them, saying, Oh, do not do this abominable thing that I hate. But they did not listen or incline their ear to turn from their wickedness, to burn no incense to other gods. So my fury and my anger were poured out and kindled in the cities of Judah and in the streets of Jerusalem, and they are wasted and desolate as it is this day. So Jeremiah reminds the people that God's judgments have come upon the kingdom of Judah and the city of Jerusalem because of their disobedience. There's a reason. And these different judgments were not only predicted ahead of time by Jeremiah and some of the other prophets, but they've actually come to pass at this point. The Babylonians have come, spent 2.5 years surrounding Jerusalem, invaded all the other cities there, and have killed the ringleaders and taken the rest off to captivity in Babylon. So this shouldn't be any big surprise, you know. This is something that they were told would happen if they didn't turn, and they didn't turn, and it happened. So, okay, I get it. And remember this also, all these things happened, all the Babylonians came and all this happened, only after God warned them through his servants, the prophets, and they disregarded it. Only after they had the warning and God pled with them not to do it, only then did these things come to pass. They just weren't faithful, and boom, it did happen. And God is owning all that happened to them. He's not passing the buck anywhere. He's saying, yes, I caused it. I, God, caused it. So he says right here, you have seen all the calamity that I brought on Jerusalem and on Judah. I did it, says he. He's not ashamed of it. He wants them to know that he's been trying to work for them. Rather than abandon them, he's applied himself more closely to them, trying to help. And so what should they realize today as they sit kind of depressed in Egypt? Well, maybe they should think about this. If he didn't abandon them before, but instead chastened them even further, what is he going to do now? Now that this whole set of people have disregarded his explicit instructions. Not only that, but after they asked him, what should we do? And then they turned around and did the very opposite of what God said. What is God going to do now? And you know, the fact is, they are only prolonging the suffering. That's what they're doing. And for you and I, if we are in disobedience to God and disregard for him, disregard for his commandments and his ways, and we refuse to turn to him, what are we doing? You and I then are prolonging our suffering, can we say it, until we do turn back to him. And I want to say this in a loving way, but as firmly as I think the word teaches it, listening to the prophets that God sends is not optional for our well-being. Just something to keep in mind. Let's pray together. Dear Father in heaven, give us ears to hear your prophets. Give us ears to hear your Bible writers and your prophets. We need your counsel. We kind of think we can do it on our own and it'll all work out in the end. Lord, help us to seek your ways, do your ways. Help us to be people who are people of the book. Very few people of the book these days. May we incline that way. May you help us, Lord, so that we can have your counsel and live the way you would have us to live. This is a big prayer that we ask of you, a big favor, a big gift we're asking from you in Jesus' name. Amen. So the people refused to hear, and then God did exactly what he said he would do. There are lessons in that for us, aren't there? God be with you today.